welcome back to our Proactive Studios. I'm Natalie Stoberman, joined by the CEO and Chairman of SmartCard Marketing Systems, Massimo Barone. Massimo, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Same here, Natalie. Thank you for inviting me.
Pleasure's all mine, and the pleasure's also all mine to be able to introduce you to our investor community. So how does the company specialize from e-commerce to even as far as fintech, paytech, and also blockchain?
Well, you know, at SmartCard, we specialize in developing commerce strategies. Those commerce strategies are specific to helping banks or enterprises develop a strategy for their multi-tenant market. And when I say multi-tenant, it means different types of merchants that they may have in their bucket of customers and use our applications as white label services to help drive new revenues and transactions by providing those services across their portfolio.
Now, this is a wide array of specialties with the company. How has SmartCard Marketing Systems been able to develop such a wide reach?
Well, we had put a focus on paytech because that's really our specialty is payments or embedded payments, cross-border payments. As you know, today, they're very intricate in making everything work, you know, because the ultimate game for everyone is how do you collect or how do you take payments? But in the fintech arena, especially even with blockchain, you need a framework or wireframe that you can enable your whole ecosystem. So we take our applications, our marketplace applications in essence, and we white label them for those institutions for them to provide the whole bucket or basket of utilities and protocols that their clients can use to facilitate easier, seamless transactions.
Mm-hmm. And as the company continues to focus on blockchain, for example, and other fintech and different applications associated with that, what does this past year look like for SmartCard Marketing Systems?
That's a loaded question, Natalie. As you know, you move in one direction and the SEC and everyone else decides that you should be moving in another. We've been fortunate because our primary goal is to work with digital IDs and EKYC and EKYB, which is how you validate and authenticate your clients and register them and onboard them. So our main focus is to bring that technology forward. Then from there is how do you validate them in the network and make them a trusted customer so that you can deal safely and reward them for participating. Now, the same is, as you know, with ACC, they're trying to grapple with the whole unregulated arena of crypto / blockchain and fintech. And they're trying to figure out some maybe generic method to apply rules to all of it, which is a difficult task.
Very difficult, and I'm sure it could be frustrating at times, but it's still crypto is so new to the game that only time will tell, and you guys need a lot more time. Everybody in the crypto space needs a lot more time. So Massimo, speaking of time, what can we expect to see from the company for the rest of this year?
Well, we put a big focus on providing compliance and regulatory solutions that come with our platforms. As you know, the last month or even in the last few days, the SEC really stomped their foot and made it clear on who will and who won't operate in the future. So our, you know, forward navigation is that we apply those rules and make sure that our bank partners or customers follow those rules. They're ahead of the curve and we remain intact. So for 2023, I think the biggest footprint we want to put ahead is that digital ID and digital assets or tokens is key in the market. Also reflected by the CEO of MasterCard, who made a very rewarding statement to the industry about tokenization.
Well, Massimo, it seems like this will be a very exciting year for a lot of companies in this industry, including your own. So we can't wait to hear more updates. Thank you so much for sharing SmartCard Marketing Systems with us.
Thank you, Natalie, for having me. Pleasure.
Yes, again, the CEO and Chairman of SmartCard Marketing Systems, Massimo Barone.